Dear Franklin, we regret to inform you that the treatment and medication you are receiving will be discontinued as of the end of this week. This is due to a lack of funding from the state. Regretfully, St. Joseph Management. Do I even exist? These fucking people pass me by and don't even look me in the eyes. Am I invisible? No one listens. No one cares. When I speak, no one seems to hear me. Is this really happening, or is this just my crazy acting up again since I stopped taking my meds? Those meds did nothing but make me feel numb inside and dull my senses anyway, chemically castrating me so I don't reproduce and make any more crazies. As if I could even convince a member of the opposite sex to find me attractive enough to procreate. I don't need those stupid meds. They won't change me. They won't help me. These people, they listen to their podcast about other people's lives and dream about an existence better than their own. They look like soulless robots marching about their days with their mobile devices attached to their hands, their earbuds fixed tightly in their ears, flitting about their days as isolated in their own little worlds as I am in mine. These people cannot think for themselves, but instead succumb to the influences of the media telling them what to believe in. Am I even the same species as these people? Do I even belong in this world? Because I felt much safer inside the hospital. Hey you, where do you belong? All I have are negative thoughts, but no one cares to listen to the rantings of a crazy person. These people walking down this street would just as soon spit in my face than say a simple hello. No one gives a fuck about crazy people. Even the prisoners get better funding than the clinically insane. What can I do to make people listen to me? Do I even want them to listen to me? I've seen the way my mother looks at me with that utter look of disdain.
Why can't you be more like your brother? At least he can hold a damn job.
She is afraid of what I might do to myself if left alone. And she should be. I don't understand this world where no one speaks to each other anymore, and if they do, it's usually just to spew venom with their words. I don't understand. What kind of society would send a mentally ill person like myself back into this shitty world with no one to talk to, and no way to take care of myself? What makes these angry people any better than me? Some of them are no better at stifling their emotions than I am. I tried to talk to my mother, but it only made it worse.
You can only stay here one night, and then you gotta take your shit and leave. You always have to say everything that comes into your mind. What am I gonna do with you?
If my own mother, doesn't want me in her house, where do I go? I have nowhere else to go. The only place that I felt comfortable has thrown me to the curb as if I'm just a piece of trash. All I do is frighten anyone I come into contact with. I've never felt more alone and isolated. It's just so goddamn hard to try and be happy when no one gives a fuck whether I live or die. And everything is going to shit all around me. Maybe this world will be better off with one less crazy person around, making the normal folks feel uncomfortable and scared. I feel like a burden to my mother, who just lacks the strength to deal with someone my issues. Maybe everyone would just be better off if I take myself out of the equation. What do I really have to offer this world anyway? The only people that listened to my problems were therapists paid by the state. And when the money stopped coming in, so did this. Not like they were much help to begin with, but at least I had someone to talk to with my negative issues. Now, I have no one. No one. Isolated and alone. I feel like my life is just one big joke. Maybe after I'm gone, they will understand. It will be too late for me. But maybe, just maybe, my actions will show the importance of assisting folks with mental health issues, instead of cutting their funding and sending them out into the street alone and isolated. Everything is starting to go black. It's fitting that I die alone, because that's how I feel inside anyway. Don't worry, Mom. I won't be staying another night.